FRS, BRC, whatever. High speed overdrive is useless, as I said in my other video. Handles extremely well for a car of its age. It's comfortable. Rides relatively well. Really doesn't have a whole lot of pickup in fifth, unless you're cruising down a highway. Power band is pretty much from 3,500 to 5,500. Anything above that, it just kind of falls flat. Anything below that, and you're pretty much in gas economy mode. It's a pretty noticeable difference when it climbs on at the cam. I was wrong in my other video. This actually has 430 rear gears, limited slip, and here's where I am. The tack running about 45. So yeah, you can see where that would be a problem on the highway. Engine is relatively smooth. It's a very mid-range engine, which is how it should be in a street car. I've been able to get this car to keep up with things like a 07 Civic Si, 2011 Civic Si, all manner of WRXs, what have you. It's honestly for what you can find these for. These, they're like the they're a lot like the new FRS, except they handle a little bit better. They are a little bit quicker. They are not as good on gas. Parts are much, much harder to find. But as far as 1 year of ownership goes, it's been pretty good as of 1 year and a few weeks. I have changed a water pump, rear shocks, coming up on a radiator change, replaced a windshield, replaced a thermostat. This speedometer still doesn't work, and I have no idea why. I think the cable's broken, which is a common issue on these cars. I do have upgraded shocks on this, so it does ride a little rough. It's a little bumpy. And of course, mine has a hole in the muffler, so it's pretty loud. And I am running wider tires stock. We're coming up on an exit ramp here. See if I can get a good also for downshifting, the paddles are way too far spaced. Well, it won't work. Trust me, I tried. At 2 grand. I thought that was interesting. it as a two-seater. I've gotten four people in here before. It was not easy, believe me. And that's pretty much my quick rundown on the Supra Mark II. For what you can find these for, for a rear-wheel drive sports coupe, I really don't think you can do any better. It's a perfect blend of cheapness, practicality, and fun.